and the ball goes to the hands of Braxton Marshall. Picks it up on the bounce. Throws it to the end zone. Pass caught! Touchdown, Emporia State! How about that? Wow! What a catch in the end zone. Justin Brown making the catch. I couldn't.
Gave up too many opportunities we didn't capitalize on. In the second half, we knew what we could do, and defense knew that they were going to stop them, and all we needed to do was throw up 20 points, and that's what we did. And, you know, it was a good team win, and that's what football's all about.
Yeah, there's no doubt. I just
need to play better in the second half. I felt like I played a little bit better, and guys made a lot of plays, you know, and Landon, he's been running the ball hard.
O-line's getting the job done up front.
Yeah, it was good to see the second half of putting up 20 points and a half, something we haven't done all season, something we need to do in the locker.
Yeah, that was kind of by design, something they were giving us. Some coaching needs to join up in the locker room. And, you know, in high school, I ran the ball a lot, so I'm not scared to run it and come out here. And, you know, you just got to execute. So.
Yeah, I think it shows a lot about us. You know, we're resilient, and, you know, we rely on each other. You know, so we relied on defense to keep them 17. They relied on us to get to 20, and we both did that. And you know, that goes a long ways, and we can trust each other on both sides of the ball, and we're just looking to continue that throughout the next 8 weeks.
Greg, I played baseball, so I'm pretty used to throwing those sidearm ones. Just something free. That was like backyard football all over again. You know, just doing something crazy. And JB's such a good player, and he makes those big time plays, and that was something we needed right there.
It feels amazing. We didn't come out very strong in the first half offensively. We knew they were going to come out swinging. On offense, being homecoming, it's a big game for them as far as a lot going on. And our defense did a great job absorbing the blow in the first half. And you know, we kind of struggled obviously in the first half, didn't get anything on the board, but we made some adjustments and we, I guess, kind of absorbed their blow and came out swinging in the second half. And props to the coaches. You know, great game plan and. Great play with the offensive line, opening holes for me and all the other backs. And, you know, we just did what we had to do to get it done. Just respond. We weren't executing at all. I mean, I think so far this year we haven't come out the way we need to come out and play. And we responded in the second half, and it's just, you know, that's the message to the guys coming into halftime is just, you know, settle down and just play your brand of football the way we're capable of playing. We all know what we can do. And defense, you know, they took some blows, and then they kept fighting and held them throughout the first half. And, you know, we had to step up and make plays for them. And I think we did that. We came out and responded really well in the second half. Offensive line play has been incredible. The stats may not show up for Kai, but that man ran hard. You know, I don't know how many tackles he broke when he scored that touchdown. I mean, he had, it seemed like, six or seven guys crawling on him, and he just forced his way into the end zone. And Braxton, you know, I think him along with everybody else in the first half, we kind of were out of our rhythm and came in second in the halftime and made adjustments, and he came out and executed in the second half. Like you said, he ran the ball well, too. So. We just got to keep the momentum going in the run game, and that'll help the pass game, you know, as we move on. Yeah, I think we got the message across really well at halftime. Just, you know, settle down, come out and play our brand of football. And you said the seniors, you know, we gave the message and set the tone, and the younger guys did a great job following along. You know, we prepare in the spring and in the winter and all through spring ball and fall camp for moments like this where we have to face adversity, and I think we responded really well.
Yeah, thank you. That's a great win for our players. Our guys just showed some grit, showed some character there the second half. It's always tough to play in the MIAA on the road. You know, coming in here, this is a nest. I mean, it was they're ready to play. Big crowd, homecoming. They're setting it 2-0. got a team that's you know, won a lot of games here recently in the MIAA coming in. I know they had this game circled, and they played, you know, well the first half. They did a really good job. We didn't play very well defensively, and offensively we just couldn't finish drives. I thought we moved the ball, we just couldn't finish drives. And played a lot better there in that second half. Got stops, got three and outs when we needed to, and played a lot better offensively. Not really. Maybe a little bit, Reed. I think our biggest adjustment was really just put the tight end in the game with his hand on the ground, you know, and just seeing how they were going to line up to that. Because, you know, when you have a tight end in the ground, now you truly have the threat of running the football. So now you know how they're going to play the box. And that was really huge for us. And I thought, you know, we did a great job of adjusting on the board at halftime kind of what our package was going to be the second half. And our guys trusted it, and I told them, you know, number one, we got to believe. I think, you know, just with us struggling offensively, I think there's frustration that set in that first half, and guys maybe got a little bit out of their element just trying to make some things happen, and instead of just trusting what we do and letting the game, you know, come to them and not feel like that we got to press it. So at halftime, that was the big discussion, just trusting it and believing in what we're doing, and you know, defense going to play better. I thought we figured out the speed of how their option game is going to be, especially with the quarterback position. Sometimes it takes you a while to kind of get adjusted to that. And then offensively, like I said, I mean, the big thing to me was Braxton playing the way that he played the second half. That's the Braxton Marshall that I'm used to seeing. And, you know, he made some plays. He made some plays when plays broke down. And that's not what we've seen this year. And he trusted it and just played a lot better the second half. Well, an offensive play, if he's yelling fire out there and somebody can hear him, then we don't have a crowd. Because, I mean, one thing, we had a run play call to the pass play, and it was a bad snap. Braxton made a play. That was an unbelievable play right there. And I tell you, another play he made was when they intercepted the ball early in the first half. Ricochet, you know, that interception, we got to catch that ball right there. Their corner made an interception, took it down there. Braxton made a tackle. You know, we fought his tail end off right there to make the tackle. And that's what you got to have to win games on the road. There's plays that you got to make on the road, and he was able to do that. That was a huge play. You know, he did. I tell you, Trenton is – we felt like going into this year, if we just said, hey, Trenton, guess what? You're going to play tight end with your hand down. That's all you're going to do. Understand what your role is. Accept it and be strong at it. And I tell you, he did a great job. And he can really help us there. Gives us another element to our game now as far as offensively, as far as how somebody's going to defend us. Because we can run the football. I mean, that's the thing about it this year, is we can run the football. We can be physical when we need to be physical. And hopefully on down the road, it opens up things that we're used to doing and playing the way with tempo, like you said, Reed, more so. I was trying to get some adjustments made on offense, Greg, and that's why, you know, I trust my coaches, my assistant coaches, and those guys have done a great job here the first two games. You know, they got it corrected. I mean, I don't know if we truly made a big adjustment or we just started playing better. And like I said, just got adjusted to kind of how the speed of the game was going to go with their option football. That shows a little bit about the resiliency of this football team and kind of where we're at within our football program. And our guys just weren't going to accept losing the game. Now we made it difficult. You know, we had a face mask call on a run play by our offensive lineman there that we weren't able to run the clock out, okay, because stopped the clock. And then we had a pass interference call over there on the sidelines, on their sidelines, you know. And those are things that we do got to get cleaned up because they're going to cost us. But, again, our guys dug down, you know, showed some grit, showed some character right there, and ended up finishing the game out with a win.